check out Kill Theory.
Hey, put the camera down.
Not till Nicole says it and means it.
I love you.
Bathroom's on the right.
I can't believe we're gonna graduate.
The dock bar is officially open.
You know, last time we did this was on that cruise we took freshman year.
It's been a great four-year ride. I just want all of you to know I couldn't have traveled it with better people.
Oh my God, what does that say?
I love you.
You all have the same option. The choice to end someone else's life to save your own. There's only one way out. Kill your friends or die with them.
Don't leave me.
I'm not leaving.
At 6 a.m., if one person is alive, they go free. If six comes and more than one is alive, everybody dies.
No!
Oh, somebody must be outside!
Oh my God!
Who do you trust the most? Your boyfriend?
Girlfriend. Here, we gotta go to the van.
You have 60 seconds.
Leave us alone!
Brett, settle down!
30 seconds.
We are all going to burn! No!
Deep down, we're all killers.
Alright, as you can see in the trailer, starts out like any other movie of its kind. College kids, high school kids, whatever, it's always the same. They get together for a weekend at the house where their parents are always rich and wealthy and have, you know, massive acres of land in a beach house or, you know, on the lake with the yacht. Same movie. But, you know, it wasn't too bad. It starts, though, 10 minutes in. I'm going, am I going to survive this movie? Because I'm not so worried about them in the movie dying. I don't know if I'm going to make this. And again, you get the, you know, cliche douchebags that are in every movie. So I'm going, well, hopefully they die first, but I might have to go before they do because, again, I'm 10 minutes in this crying. Like, it's really painful. Like, I can still feel it in my sides. But then something cool happens, and that's time advancing. Because at 24 minutes, I'm like, hey, all right, wasn't that bad. Just sucks in the beginning. Really sucks in the beginning. Boring. But, again, 24-minute mark, I'm like, so, yeah. Then at that point, though, we go back and forth and back and forth. So then it's cool. Keeps your attention, but then it fades, and then you got the other people who really, they just kill them, get rid of them already. They're annoying to begin with. Just eliminate them, keep the cool people, make the movie about them. So I'm like, yay. Ooh, yay. So it goes back and forth again. But summing up, eye candy. Fun thing with eye candy, you got a movie again with a bunch of college people who are all going away for the weekend. Everyone's hooking up. And you really don't get any skin. They don't show anything, even though everyone's always, you know, talking about making out and having sex, because, again, that's the cliche movie. But minimal nudity. The only nudity in the movie, girl dies, you know, like 10 seconds later. Not to ruin it, but you're not missing anything. So I give it a 3. Memorable lines, scenes. 4. And that's probably only because I remember these scenes from other movies. Gore and effects. There's some gore there. I mean, it's gruesome at times, but it's also filmed so dark because it's always nighttime. They gotta make it to 6 a.m. So you don't even get to see real details of stuff. So 4. Acting. It's what it is. I mean, right in the middle, give it a 5. But hey, average all that up, comes to a 4. So it's not the worst thing. We've done better, but we've seen worse. So till next time, thanks.